Hi, this is Christopher from Fancy Loom Boys, and I will be showing you today how to make a Chespin figure that has a tail. So, let's get started. The supplies you'll be needing are your Alpha Loom, your Alpha comb, a rainbow loom hook. It doesn't matter if it's metal or not. Lots of green bands. 7 black bands. 2 orange Alpha Loom bands. 2 white Alpha Loom bands. About 10 brown Alpha Loom bands. And a lot of skin-colored Alpha Loom bands. And if you don't have brown or tan or any of these colors, you can just use regular rainbow loom bands for each color. So the first thing we will be doing is putting green bands for the top. So first, we have to put a green band twisted on the middle pin, like that. And then we also do that same thing on the outer pins, the two outer pins. Like that. On these three. And then we put another layer of bands on top of those three. Like that. And before we loop the three, put two more green bands on the on these two. This one and this one, like that. And now we can use our hook to take up the middle the two outer ones. See there, so like that. And now we are going to put another row of bands on all five, just normally. Earlier, I realized that I'm wearing a Pokemon shirt and I'm doing a Pokemon tutorial. And it was funny when I realized that. And now we are going to put two more green twisted bands on the two rows that don't have any bands yet. Like that. And now we can use our hook to take up the bottom layer. And then we push them down. Just using my finger. You can use your Alpha comb for that. And I'm sorry, but I forgot to mention that we need clear Alpha loom, I mean clear rainbow loom bands to connect these bands together so they don't end up 7 bracelets instead of a figure. And now we have to do green on all 7 rows on our Alpha Loom. And now you can use your Alpha comb or a hook take up that clear band and those green bands. All right, I just have trouble doing this when I have to do it this way. So I usually do it the way I like it, but I'm trying. And you can also push the bands down with your comb. And it should look like that. Now twisted bands. And now we use another clear band. And we are now only using green on the outer two pins. And if you've done my chest pin charm tutorial, then the head should be a little easier. Because you already know what's coming. You can put three brown bands on here. And if you don't have this color, then you can just do what you did. If you've watched my chest pin charm tutorial, you can double the bands because the rainbow loom bands are bigger, and you can make them looped around twice. And you also use two skin color alpha loom bands like that. And again, if you don't have this color, you can use tan like rainbow loom bands. Sorry, I just can't do it the way that I try. And it should look like that. And you push the bands down. And now, put another clear band. Like that. And put two green ones on the outside. And now we're only using one brown. Like that. And now put the skin color on the rest of these bands. It's just slipping away. Like that, and now you can use your alpha comb or a hook to take that clear band up. Mine didn't go all the way. And take that side and turn the loom around. Like that, and push your bands down. And now we are going to put another clear band on. And this is our eyebrow. Our chest pin's eyes are going to be. And the black eyes are going to be on this row right here. And the row right here. Like that. And now you can put two green alpha loom bands on the outside like we've been doing. And now the rest are just going to be skin color again. Didn't grab enough. I need to grab three. Wait, that's enough. I thought I needed four. Like that. And now you can use your comb to take the bottom layer up and over like that. Green on these two, skin color on these two, black on these two, and skin color in the middle. And you can push your bands in, down. And right now you can see Chespin's little spikes on his head. And sometimes this part reminds me of a transformer with the head. Like that. And now put another clear band on. Just going to keep that out here. And put two more green ones. Like that. And now we're just going to use all five. Rows are going to have skin color. And we've got 4 out of 5. And now you can take the clear band up. But it doesn't go all the way. Like that. And go to the other side. And it should look like that. And now we are going to do both the mouth and the nose. The start of the mouth and also we are going to do the nose. So the mouth is going to start on these two rows. Like that. And put one orange band in the middle. That one. And of course, put 2 green bands on the outer ones. And then you can put skin color like that. Green, black, skin, orange. And now you can loop that up. And that's what it should look like. And now you can pull Justin's head a little. And in this row, we are going to finish the mouth. So we put a clear band on. Another 2 green on there. And we are going to use our last 3 black in the 3 middle rows. These 3. And the other 2, we're not using skin this time. We're using brown. The other 2. Like that. And now take clear band. Stop doing that. Like that. And now you can start pulling the top of your chest pin. Then you can see the little eyes coming in. You can see all the spikes there. Like that. This one. This one. And this one. If they're all curled up, you can just pull them and then they'll straighten out. And now you can put another clear band on. And this is our last row. This is one of our last rows using green. Like that. And we're going to use a green later on, but just not for the head. That's what it should look like. Green, skin color, skin color, skin color. And now you can put clear band on and take the bottom layer up that side like that. And the other side like that. And push it down with your palm. And you can pull the chest pin a little like that. It should look like this now. We are going to take these green bands and move them over one. Like that. Just use your hook to grab this and hold it with your finger. So it doesn't fall off the hook. And this should be easy if you've seen my other tutorials, because I do this a lot. Like that. And now another clear band. And just a whole row of skin and before we loop these, put another skin tone band twisted right there, like that, and on the other side. And now we don't want to use our comb. You don't want to use your comb because it could pull up the outside too. So use your hook, take up these bands one by one. Like that, and you push your bands down. Unfold the chest pin, and now you can see the little smile coming in. And now we are on the body, finally. Put another clear band on. And we're just going to do a whole row of skin color. Like that. And now use your comb to stop doing that. Okay, no, not you. The clear band just won't come up. And use your comb to take these bands up. Like that. And push them down. And pull the chest pin. Like that. And now we are not going to do all skin color this time because we are using brown for the arms. Yay! Oh, wrong pin. And before we do the arms, we're just going to put skin tone on the 5 middle ones, just not the outside one. Like that. And leave these 2 uncut on. And now we are going to make the arms. So use your hook. This is the only thing you need to use to make these. Just use the color that you want for the arms, which is what. And if you don't know any of my other tutorials, like, that have arms, then you've known how to do this. And take the cap band off. And what I did there was just wrap one brown band around the hook 2 times. And then I put another band above it and just took the cap band onto that band. And I'm going to do that without twisting it 3 more times without twisting another band. And that does not mean I'm doing it 4 arms and I'm having trouble getting the other end of my hook. Like that. Your hook should look like that. And now it's another brown band. And if you're doing this with regular brown bands, rainbow loom bands, brown, then you have to still you have to wrap it around 4 times for wrap the cap band 4 times around it, but for the twisted bands, you just have to do it two times, like a regular cap band. Like that, and I'm going to use I'm just checking how many I need. And do that one more time. Like that. And I'm not going to take the other end on there. I'm going to use my fingers. I'm going to slide this one over and get this part under my fingers like that. And I'm going to put it on my loom like that. And do that again. Okay. Wrap it around once like that, or twice. And that fell off, but luckily it wasn't on that band. Oops, I don't have enough brown bands with me. I need two more. There. And now I can continue. Like that. Like that. And put it on the hook again. And now I have the cap band. 1, 2, 3 non-twisted ones. And I have to do that one more time. That like that, and like I did before, just take the other side like that, and it should be in the middle of your two fingers that you're using, or your finger and a hook, or two hooks. But I don't have two hooks with me, so I won't need to do that. And it should look like that. And now, take up your clear band and the bottom layer. And push the bands down. And now you can see the head more. You should look like that. With the little smile coming together, almost. And now I've got another clear band. We are about halfway done this now. And now just put a whole row of clear again, like we did before the arms. Like that, and now take your band up on the bottom, and the clear band too, I'm sorry. Like that, and push the bands down, like that, and now just do the same thing, but all seven. Jumping on all seven again. And take your clear band out. And take those bands up on the bottom. It should look like that. And push the bands down. And I'm just going to make sure it's something. So we're going to do that same thing two more times until we do the feet. So seven more bands. After you put the clear band, of course. Like that. Sorry, one of my bands was going with the hook that was not supposed to go, so I... oops, almost dropped it. Okay, now I can... Just... Oh my gosh! This band just keeps going down when I grab the other ones. And I just keep grabbing it. Then I have to stop. And get that off of it. And now you can see the full head going together like that. Looks really cute. And you can pull the arm a little. But you might not want to pull it too hard or that clear band will be showing right there. And now we are going to do a full row of just regular skin tone Alpha Loom bands for the last time. So we do the feet. And I need two more for my pile over there. And like that. And take the clear band up again. And take those bands up, and those bands up, push them down, and pull a little, see your Chespin more, like that, and now we are finally on the feet, and now you need a bunch of skin tone, pink bands, in your two whites. And we're going to use our hook again. And first, put a white band on there once and on there twice. And now we are going to use three of our skin tone pink and do what we did just like the arm, except just one less. Like that, and it should look like that so far. And one more. Sorry, I'm just sniffing a lot. And don't put it on your loom. Don't put both parts there. Put the, just like we did for the arms. And I keep doing that. Every time I do this, I forget to put the clear band on before I do the arms and have it in my hand. Or feet or whatever. I keep doing that. And if you did that too, it's okay. You're not the only one. And I guess if you do it, I'm not the only one either. and do that like this. If one of these parts is out like that, all you have to do is just pull the other end and then even it out like that. And now I'm just using one more. And laying it off of my hook with my two fingers. That. And like that. And now we're just going to use 5 more skin tone pink Alpha Loom bands again. At least this one wasn't like a boring regular roll. One more. Like that. And now that, pull them over. Same problem from earlier. It's only happened once this time. And pull. And now you can see the arms better. You can see the arms, and you can pull a little. Like that. Here. And now what we're going to do is pull these two, this row, over to the next over like we did for the green part of the head. We're just going to pull it over. Ugh, my hook went out of my hand and I let it go. Like that. And I put another clear band. And now do that. And get 5 more of these. And these are our last of this color. So we are almost done. Like that, and now take the clear band, oops, I never grabbed it, and take the bottom ones up, and it's kind of hard because there's two on the same pin, and like that, and now push them down, and we're almost done. Now we just have to take this side of the band to that side. Like that. And now, if you've watched a bunch of my other ones, and you know how to do this last part, except we are going to do a little different. Take the bottom part, and I'm just going to do it the way I can see it. Take the bottom part that was already on this side off and over, so that the part that we took over to this side is the only one on there. And now we can't use our comb to push these down, so we have to either pull or push them down. Like that, and oh, never mind, sorry. Wrong side. Like that, and now take over, not like take over a building, no. Take over these, that to the, I mean, that one to this one. Go behind, go in front of that. Make sure it's, and then take the bottom one up. And if that band that we looped in front of is trying to come off, that's okay because it's connected to this band. And now all we have to do is the same thing for this side. And take this one up. And like that. Over to this one. And that came off, but that's okay as long as I have this band. Like that. And keep that last one on your hook because you're going to need to. And now you can pull a little to make it better. And you can choose which side that looks better if you just move it around eventually, and it'll look better once you pull it around. So that happens to me a lot. And then I just fix it by moving it around and squishing it. Because then the clear band side doesn't show. And now we are just going to use three of our green bands and our last orange. And this is what Chespin looks like so far. Now we are going to do the tail. Take, if we're doing just like we did for the arms and feet, except it's not going to be any twisted ones. Like that. Take that over to that, like this. And do the same with another one. Like that. And pull it over to that. And it should have two. And now you do the last green. And now we are done with green. And now we are going to do orange. Our last orange out of the two that we had. And like that. And now we are going to get a C-clip. And I forgot to mention that too. And clip the orange parts. And now we are finished. Like that. And I have three of these now. This is the one we just made. And this is another one, and I have this one. Well, with its tail on the front for some reason. But you can just push it to the back. And I have three. And now, my sneak peek for my next tutorial. You're going to really like this one if you like Minecraft. It's Diamond Armor Steve. He's big. So this tutorial will take a while.